Hello everybody, and welcome to Locking Call. Today, I'm going to pick a lock that was sent to me by Ryan McCreary, and the lock I'm going to pick is by Bronx. It is called Lefty. Only turns to the left. So, yeah, we're going to do that, I think. I think I should have everything I need. I'm just gonna try to make sure I have all the stuff I need to get it. Let's see here. So this looking this way. Okay, here we go. Lefty. Kick cylinder with the Wiser key. Weird. Oh, there it is. There it is. I got it to turn left. Okay, it works. It works good. Got some lows in the front here. A couple highs. And then that one hiding in behind. Left, right, left. So, need all my things. Left. Okay, we are at 247. Okay, now I need a pick. Attention. E49, here we go. Nice little click. Nice. Everything was pretty soft here. Nice click there. Another slight click. There we go. Nice little click and some turning. Left. Go to the left. Come on now. I'll click there. Some churning happening now. Some false setting. Oh, a little more. Come on now, where are you? Got some of our false setting back, and we got a nice pin up here in the front, if I can get it to set. Come on now, set. Let's see if I got anything else here. Alright, well, got my false set back. Good little pick, though. That's all that matters. Probably what it'll be. Oh, come on now. Where are you? There it is, folks. Holy awesome. Deadly picking. So minus 3:48 from 9:40 something, and that's how long it took me to pick it. Okay. Hmm. Awesome lock. Holy. Deadly. So that probably took me around. Okay, if I started at 3:48 and I stopped at like 9:40 or something like that. Yeah, that was 3:38. Pretty sure. Somewhere around there. I can always check and double check. There's a spring in there. Still no. No shizzle. Okay. I have shim. Where the shim went. Oh, jeez, guys. Wonder if I could. I don't want to risk it, because if this goes all kabooey, I don't want that to happen. So please just bear with me. Oh, one good shim left. Uh-oh. One good shim left. Get all the way in there. There we go. Now it's the bigger one. That's the smaller one. Please, please, please. Oh, perfect, perfect. Nice, I'm right through. Okay. Using Ryan's Nazi tray. Oops. Oh man. Okay. I'm pretty sure it was like this. Like that. But I can check. Oh no. That one must have been pin number 5 or something. I'm just gonna check quick here so I can get this for hanging on. Yeah, it looks good. So, I'm gonna have to get used to it. 2. Beautiful pins as well. Very beautiful pins. I must say the pins fit in those chambers really well, Ryan. Okay. Undercuttings in 1 and 2. And threads in 3, 4, and 5. On to the good stuff. So crowded, I can't move right now. Okay, here we go. Try this again. I'm blocking my light source right now. Okay, that's front. Oh, beautiful pin, Bronx. There's a little copper spring there. Doesn't seem to want to come out. I got him. Where is there? Jesus. Man. I can't seem to get the springs out of here. They're in there pretty good. And the one thing I do not have is springs. I might have a few. Maybe I have enough to like do one lock. I'm just gonna get on with the pins for right now. That might help, eh, meathead? It's not helping at all. Okay, number 6 pin. Or number 5 pin, sorry. Number 4 pin. Spring number 5. Hopefully I can get this guy out. And then the last one right there. Excellent spring. I'm almost at 20 minutes here.